Hey, hi.
Hi, you're connected?
Yes, I am here.
So I'm sorry for this, like, all of a sudden podcast thing, because I'm also experimenting with how Anchor is working and all.
Yes. And this is good. Anchor is good, actually. I have used this one time.
So that's what, like, I saw a few videos of Gary Vaynerchuk and how he's emphasizing more on voice and all. That's why I thought that, you know what, let's give it a shot.
Yes, nice.
So I thought we can just start this topic with this whole Instagram organic reach controversy. Like, so many people around are complaining that it has gone below 5%. And like, so what's your take on that?
Yes, you're right. Actually, even I have noticed that organic reach has drastically fallen down. Even with my followers, if I post anything, I'm not getting that much reach earlier I used to get. So I think there is something changes in the algorithm. So yeah, it's I mean from the business point of view, they are also right. How why they will give you such kind of free organic reach
So
using the free organic reach. This is what I think.
if I share my experience, I have spent like anywhere around 1,000 to 1,500 rupees behind Instagram. Like, I have experimented it, I have used it myself.
Okay.
So my whole take on that was that even after paying for those Instagram ads, the quality of audience where my content was being showed was not that good. Like, I put the right amount of tags, I used the right location and all, I set the perfect age group, but the audience which was being shown were people who were having open accounts. Now, I'm not telling having open accounts is a crime, but in 2019 in Instagram, usually I've noticed this genuine people, they don't keep their accounts open. So who keep their accounts open? They are the newbies. They are the new users, or probably those who live in the external rural areas. Getting my point?
Yes.
That audience has nothing to do with my content, and they were being pushed my content. And that's why, like, after spending that minimum ad budget of like 40 rupees, what you have to spend for each ad, I was getting like hardly one or two followers who were actually following my account.
Yeah, I don't know, but I have heard the same thing for book since last 6 months, that you are not getting the dollar you spent on Facebook ads. But Instagram, I don't know, like we might be wrong on our side also on targeting. We might not know properly how to target. But I think Instagram ads are good actually. The ROI is good than Facebook. If you spend your 60 rupees on Facebook, Instagram, then the ROI on Instagram is good than Facebook, because very less people use Instagram ads. People are more on Facebook. Don't know, they are not getting that much ROI. So, but yeah, compared to Facebook, Instagram is good. But I don't know about your case. Even I have tried for my post, like general post for experimenting. So I spent like 250 rupees. So followers, but I got a good reach. Yeah, though that reach kind of thing worked, but that now following thing depends on your content also, like how it is. So people will follow you. So I don't think Instagram will help in that direction, like people will follow you or not. They will just have your viewer on your door. Now it's on us to welcome that viewer.
Yeah, that is a point to it, but like, reducing the organic reach to 5% or even below that, that is actually doing harm for the platform as a whole, because they have created an entry barrier for new creators. Like, right now, the ones who we see on Instagram who are actually nailing it, those are the ones who have like made their whole career in like, they have started 3 4 years back, and that is why they have, even if they have like 10,000 or 100,000, so they are the ones who started an year back or 2 years back. So what about the ones who are actually coming new to the platform and they are trying to scale it up? For them, it is like a dead end.
I can understand. Yeah. Even I have seen this. My post, when I post something like photographs or any videos, I am getting hardly 5% or 10% reach. Hardly, I mean, and but the same thing goes with the story. I am getting a reach of 60 to 70%, believe me. On stories, I am getting very much good reach.
stories and haven't reached then this thing.
Yes, so I think there is some kind of algorithm changes. He wants to focus more on stories. I mean, short kind of Snapchat kind of thing.
Yeah.
So might be his algorithm is working on stories direction and not post. And you also know, like, recent Instagram has made many changes. They have removed that following tab.
Yeah, the whole new thing. Like, there are mixed opinions about that. As far as, like, 2 days have happened since they have announced that thing. And some people say it is good because, like Gary Vaynerchuk in his today's Instagram post, he said that it is a good step because it is promoting mental health. Many people
take
that following tab as something huge. So he said that it's a good tab. Some people say that the person has to decide. Like, okay, if you are doing it for mental health, that's perfectly fine. It's a good step, but at least keep the decision in the person's hand whether he wants to, like, hide it or show it.
Yeah, this can be an opt-in option, can be also done, like profile private or this is a good take. But even in many articles, Facebook told that hardly 5-6% of overall population of Instagram were using that feature. So I don't know what kind of maintenance they were doing on that following tab. So they thought, like, whatever we are spending on following tab, like the amount, like people who are working on following tab, we are not getting that much ROI. Like, people are not using that feature. So I think in that way they. So this was the one point I got to know from their article. Like, hardly 5-6% people were using that following tab.
How I look at Instagram is that I was just trying to think how exactly algorithms are working on this. So how I saw it was that I just checked how old is this platform. So to my astonishment, this platform is actually 10 years old. And the problem that is happening is that when Instagram was launched, like 10 years back, if I ask you or if I ask anyone, if I ask someone from a friend list that when did you join Instagram, he will obviously say 3 years, 4 years, maximum 5 years. Now, what happened with Instagram? When it was launched, Instagram was not needed when it was launched. So for the 5 years, it was under shadow, like Facebook was dominating. After 5 years of its launch, Instagram came. So still people are thinking that, alright, Instagram is a new platform. Instagram is still, like, it has just arrived. But actually it has, like, 10 years have happened. So we need to take that into consideration. Like, 10 years is a long time for a platform in this age to survive.
Yes, yes. And like, even if I tell, like, what happened in 2010. So some of the founders were from Instagram who started, like, Kevin and Mike. So those people started that thing. Facebook was doing in 2004 when Facebook started in 2004. Now they started in 2010. So what they thought was, like, we want to make it as a photo and video sharing platform. Just only photo and video. Now, so in like 2012 and 2013, I don't remember the year in which Zuckerberg realized that this is a thing. Even these founders are not realizing what Instagram it is. So then in 19 billion, Mark Zuckerberg bought Instagram. So it was not started by Facebook, but they acquired from one of the founders. So he was knowing that this is the big thing and I will.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So the algorithm at that time, organic reach in 2010, 2011 was way good, like 70-80% you can get, because there was no advertising concept at that time.
And so, that time, not just Instagram, even all the platforms, like even if the movies, you know, like till today, there are movies like Secret Superstar. Okay. We see that if you have watched the movie, have you?
Yes, I have.
So in that movie, that girl, you know, she uploads a video and then in the evening, she is coming back. Now, right now, if you're a YouTuber in India, after watching that movie, you will tell that, okay, the storyline was good. The message that they wanted to convey was good. But that part is not technically correct.
Yes.
It's not possible because she was recording with her laptop default camera. Okay. Now, that is the worst camera you can ever use in your life. Your laptop camera. It's okay. Second. She directly recorded it with that. So there was no external mic connected. There was nothing. And there was no noise cancellation also. So she directly recorded that thing and uploaded. Any guy who has even made 5 YouTube videos in his life will tell you that this piece of video will not get viral.
Yes. True.
And then we see her that she's coming back, and you know she's getting comments from abroad, she's getting comments from foreign countries that, hey, you know what, we liked your concept, we liked your videos. And that is wrong. But what people are not understanding, that used to happen. That actually used to happen like 5 years back, 6 years back, that people upload a video and like it is crossing 1,000, 2,000 views.
True, I agree on this, yaar. But I think this is the, I mean, base of business actually, like how much you can squeeze, the platforms. And later on, it becomes like an advertising platform only. You pay and you get a reach. Now on TikTok, if you say, like I have posted videos on TikTok. So I was just getting 20,000 to 23,000 views. You believe me? So when I'm posting on YouTube, I'm not getting that much reach. And when I'm posting on TikTok, I'm getting this much reach.
Yeah.
Anyway, also, he says like TikTok is the next big thing because right now you are getting maximum organic reach. Once they realize like people are more engaging in this, even in TikTok also, organic reach will fall to 20% or 10%. And later on, like after 5 years, 5%. Again, we will be making a podcast on TikTok. Like, have you heard like organic reach has fallen on TikTok? So this is the thing with every platform, I guess. So new platform comes, you get a more organic reach.
Don't you think that that creates an entry barrier? Like, okay, if you are a platform and you are like okay, if you want to cut the organic reach, cut it for those people who are like, they should keep a threshold that if you go above this count, like 10K or 100K, then obviously you have a big audience. So you won't care whether your audience, your organic reach is like good or not. Because at that time, if you are at that level, you can even pay for organic reach. So they should do something that they should cut the organic reach only for those people who actually will pay. Like, see, if I'll make this thing clear with an example. If right now I'm posting videos on Instagram, okay, and I'm working super hard, I'm like making videos, editing it properly, and then uploading it. At the end of the day, I don't get the views or the engagement that I deserve. Then what will I do? I will try Instagram ads, okay? I'll burn a couple of thousands behind Instagram ads. After that, I'll understand that, okay, putting 100, 200 rupees behind these thing, it won't fetch me anything. People are there who are putting lakhs of rupees behind this thing. So my 100, 200 will give me no benefit.
True.
So what will I do at that time? I will leave the platform, right? Now, that is actually causing hindrance. So the app should do something that they earn, they charge money from those who actually earn through Instagram. Like the people who post pictures with branded content and earn money out of it, only they should be liable to pay back to Instagram, not the all users.
Yeah, I totally understand your point actually, because that motivates you. If you get reach and if you get views, so that will motivate you to make another piece of content.
And that's actually how the platform, you know, how the platform survives. Otherwise, it will, like many people who are big in the social media game are telling that Instagram is at its end.
Yes. If I make one point, like I told you, I am getting more views on my stories. From last 2 months, I am noticing 2% of my views are coming from the blue ticks, from verified account. Can you believe?
Yeah, those are bots.
I didn't realize. I was just happy. Like people from verified account, they are the personality, they are watching my story. I was happy. But then I read some blogs and I saw some videos on YouTube. So this is making me fool actually. So I think as a platform, Facebook shouldn't do these things.
That actually what you said, that is not like a mistake from Facebook's end. That in fact, I read a blog about this same thing in which they said that the world's top 100 Instagram engagement accounts, like we have Priyanka Chopra and Kylie Jenner and all,
yes,
all, yeah, all of their accounts, 40% followers are bots. So they literally pay money directly, indirectly, whatever, but they keep their engagement high by there is monetary things happening in that. And the thing about monetary is right now, even if you download an app from Play Store to get bot likes or bot comments or bot followers on your profile, then it makes your profile liable to view others. That's how this whole ecosystem works, right? So you give the permission of your account to that bot company that you can use my account. So the way you are getting views from anonymous accounts, similarly your account will be used to give views to other people.
So this is like a third party who is acting like between two people and telling them, you like my post, I will like your post. You follow me, yeah, I will follow you. And this is the most, and this is done this by the, and this is done by another third party company.
Yeah. So I'll tell you. So if there are 10 people sitting in 10 different countries around the world, and each of them get just one like on their photos, like they are the only person who likes their own photos. Okay. And they don't even get a second like. So they get only one like, which is their own like on their photos. Now a company comes and tells them that, hey, you know what? Pay me X amount of rupees and I'll get you 9 more likes. And the company says same thing to all the 10 people. All the 10 people pay the company money. And by paying money, they also accept that thing that their account can be used by that company. And that company interchanges the views. Like the 9 accounts are shown, see the like the post of that one account. Similarly, that one account will like the post of all the 9 accounts. And that's how this whole game works.
I saw one article where Instagram says, Instagram company says, like, we will hide likes from the post. Only the author of the post can see his or her like, not their view. So like, I think that is the main crux over there. Like, people will not run behind likes and views actually.
Yeah.
And people will focus more on content. But if they don't get the organic reach, I think people will get demotivated and they will switch to other platforms.
That is a smart move to do that, because see, number one, the person who is uploading gets to see the likes. Okay, so he anyways is. And number two is that if there's no validation, how do you mark your progress? Like right now, at least we have, okay, kal tak 20 like aate the, aaj 50 like aa rahe. So we
get your progress. Yeah.
Get that, okay, this video did well, this video didn't do. But if you are removing the metrics, then how do you judge a piece of content?
Yes.
That becomes a question.
So if we come on now, let's talk on India. If we say, like, what is the future of Instagram in India?
Yeah.
So what I believe, still there are way less people in India who are using Instagram. This is what I believe. There are very less people. And this is just a data which shows like hardly 70 million or 80 million people have registered on Instagram from India, which is how much? It's like 8 crore. And we are in the population of 130 crore. And even US is bigger than us.
Yeah, true.
So I think in India, Instagram of 2013 or 12 from US.
Okay.
This is what I think. Like, still by 2023, people will be spending.
As far as I understood, what you're saying is that when this huge chunk of new population will come on Instagram, the organic reach will automatically go high. That's what you're trying to like.
I'm not saying that thing because I don't think it is on us to increase the organic reach. They have some algorithms like. Whatever kind of followers you have, whatever kind of hashtag you use, like if you use hashtag, let's say India, hashtag India. So whatever be the post related to hashtag India, hardly 1-2% will be allocated to you.
Hashtags, in fact, there is this thing, I don't know if it's true or not, but if you are like in every post, if you are using 20 to 30 hashtags, Instagram can block your account because... gets a red signal that you are doing some spam activity.
Yes. So how many followers you have, how many if you see on WhatsApp also, if you post any story, if you have 300 contacts of WhatsApp, you will not get 300 views. You will hardly get 150 or 120 or max 200.
Yeah, but WhatsApp it's not about organic reach, right? Because if you have 300
it is.
In WhatsApp, actually, if you have got 300 contacts, your status will be shown to 300 people. Then
I would like to disagree on this because I have read about this. And in Instagram also, I have 2,000 accounts, 2,000 contacts in my, but I am getting maximum reach of 400 views, not more than that. And I have also realized if I chat with any of my old friend, any of my old friend, like after 2-3 months, then suddenly the next day I can see his stories and he is also viewing my stories.
Okay, prioritization.
Prioritization. Yeah, it is happening in WhatsApp also. And same goes with the Instagram also. If you have 10,000 followers, your story will be not shown to the 10,000 followers. Your story will be shown to X number of percentage.
So yeah, that's right.
This is not in our hand. And they also increase the percentage of views according to the engagement. If more people are replying you or more people are commenting or liking your post, then they will increase the percentage. They will try to show that post to more people in your network.
Yeah, that's right.